G'day all, MrPaladin here, and today I'm playing Mechwarrior5.
We've been paid to protect the factories, Commander. All remaining units have abandoned the place. You're the only support these people have left.
And support them we shall. This is my first chance that I've ever had of having a full assault lance of mechs. So all of these are the big boys, the 100 tonners. And we're coming to the defense of this facility.
Thanks for coming, Commander. Remember that you are contracted to protect as much of this facility as possible. We'd much rather pay out your contracted bonuses than reconstruct extensive amounts of the facility.
Looks like we made it here just in time, Commander. Now fan out and take defensive positions. Prepare for incoming hostiles.
Now, while I play the mission today, I do want to talk about the state of the game. I am glad to hear that this game has not been left in the dust. There were fears of that, but it looks like PGI is keeping interest in the game. There is a patch coming out tomorrow, Wednesday, and it should be addressing one key issue that I've had where I haven't been able to sell a mech in cold storage. There are some other quality of life patches that are coming in to fix other things, especially to do with joysticks and its glitch in the training mission. So it's good. I'm encouraged. I'm glad this game is not just being a grab at the money and then a runaway. Because that was a fear, right? That they were pushing this out a little too early. They put it on the Epic Store and they were just going to grab the money and leave the franchise. But there is an AMA coming out where they're going to be talking about, you know, the future of the game, the possibilities of the DLC, which I, for one, am going to be happy. Like, it's almost guaranteed that it's going to go into the clan invasion.
The area is taking a beating, Commander. Don't give them the opportunity to cause any more harm.
For those who do follow the BattleTech universe and what happens in the timeline and the history of the game, we are expecting the clans to invade from the north. If you don't know what the clans are, or you don't know what the BattleTech universe is, I did do some lore videos not too long ago to help get you up to speed. With the clan invasion, we should see a whole bunch of different stuff in relation to the game. Without a doubt, there's going to be the clan technology and the clan mechs to expand upon, which is great because, you know, even I get tired of going into some of these missions and seeing the cicada appear like 10 bazillion times. You do see a mix of different mechs drop in, but, you know, they get familiar after a time and you start to see repetition and repetition, and no one likes repetition, especially in a single player game. The other things I'd expect to see is more environmental biomes like lunar surfaces and stuff like that. Thankfully, there won't be any underwater mission. I've never heard of an underwater mech, but then again, I don't know my Mechwarrior lore that deep. There might be an underwater mech type, who knows. Suffice it to say that all this attention from PGI and the updates and the attention given to the DLCs will mean more than likely that this game is going to last longer than its 1-year contract with Epic Games, which means after the 1 year has expired, the chance for it to go on sale on Steam will become available. And I know once it hits Steam, especially if it gets updated and or keeps seeing regular updates from PGI, it will reinvite a section of the community that flatly refused to download the Epic Game Store for various reasons. I've made several comments, several videos about that in the past. I don't think there's any reason to rehash that again. But it's their choice. They didn't want Epic. They wanted the game on Steam. It was thought to be on Steam from the inception, but that didn't pan out. But push come to shove, people have various reasons for not wanting to go to different platforms, and that's perfectly fine. Just like myself, I like to stay on YouTube, even though I could probably go to Twitch. But I'm just keeping it on the same platform here for my own ease of use. But with the DLCs being planned, that means that down the road there's going to be sales. You know, the DLC is going to be released, so the base game is going to be on sale, or it's going to end up appearing on Steam, so the other platform's going to have a sale of it, you know, to compete. That's a win for us as gamers. But all up, the more I play this game, the more I appreciate the fact that this is filling the need that I have for the single player experience of Mechwarrior, which I have not had for a very, very long time. You know, I've played previous versions of Mechwarrior, I've played the Mechwarrior Mercenary series before, and I like the way Mercenaries does it. You know, it puts you into the world as a merc pilot, or in this case, a commander of a mercenary lance. And you have to do the missions, but you also have to negotiate the contracts as you do the missions in order to get the best payouts possible to maximize everything you can. Even when I'm fighting other mechs while I'm playing missions, I'm more mindful of how I'm killing them in order to get the most amount of salvage. Or in this case, this archer is in way too close, we've got to center core him as fast as possible. Watch out for that crit! No, don't be near it! Don't be near it! I hate it when my guys are near the crit explosions. Although that costs me money. I have had several situations where the enemy mechs have been killed by their friend exploding, which is great. It's something that wasn't in Mechwarrior Online, and I'm glad it's back in the game here. But all up, my assault lance is going nice. I'm progressing in the game. The only thing I'm finding though is, even though I've got the money for an assault lance, the pilots that I have to pilot these mechs are not skilled enough for the assault mechs. And so I'm going to have to make a decision real soon. Do I go down to lower levels and allow these mech pilots to get more experience? Or do I travel to some of the more complicated areas of the game, the more difficult areas of the game, where you expect to find, you know, the more expensive mechs and such, and see if I can find mech pilots that are already skilled. And I think that's the way to go. It used to be that you'd carry over the older pilots, because the longer you had a pilot on your roster, when you promoted them, the cost of promotion was not nearly as much as paying someone right from the get-go at a high skill. The other thing I've got to see about this end game is there are only a few assault mechs that you can get in this game, because, you know, like we're saying, it's limited. We're waiting for the clan expansion and stuff like that for more mech options. So is it going to get stale? Am I only going to be piloting, you know, one, two, or three mechs in particular that are at the 100 ton that you can get in this game, because the game's kind of forcing me into this brawling out style with the bigger mechs as much as possible? Or will I be able to, you know, go down in weight class and just tweak the mechs? Or will I have to give up on the AI pilots and do the late game with other people? You know, this is a multiplayer game. I can bring people from the internet who would probably love to pilot the higher end mechs in the various difficult missions. And so long as I don't blow my arms off, I'm perfectly fine with them doing whatever. In fact, these days, you know, I was actually complaining at the start that the mech pilots would get their arms blown off, but now I realize, you know what? It doesn't matter if they get their arms blown off or not. I've got the mercenary unit covered.
Our employers will be pleased that we have held our ground and saved this facility. Good work, Commander.
And just a quick look at the damage that the AI did and how I'm gonna need new AI pilots. They're a little bit underpowered for this point in the game. I do not have great salvage with Steiner, and I was doing this mission more for reputation than anything else. So I'll just pick up a few things, even though there's some tasty mechs there in the rewards. But you'll see in a moment how the AI mech pilots that I've had with me for a while, they're just not training up fast enough to keep pace with the game. So I'm going to have to drop them from my mech pilot roster. I'm going to have to travel around, pick up some higher level NPCs so I can keep the single player game action going. Or if that's just not possible, I'm going to have to pick up some human mech pilots from the Mechwarrior5 Discord and just game with some folks. Either way, I'll show you some missions. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.